Without skipping a beat, let's dive into another new kit, AMT's 125th Peterbilt Wrecker. This is a big kit. This is a big truck. Got a lot of cool accessories in the box and an all-new decal sheet. So let's take a look at what's going to be in the box when you get yours. First up, that new decal sheet. Check it out. Lots of nice details on there. Gold striping, solid tone. And then we've got numerous Peterbilt logos. We've got numerous work logos. We've even got some lights on the side there. Nice looking decal sheet. Now, for all the plastic, I keep it from falling off the table next to me. We've got so much styrene in the box. Let's start getting it all out here. Yep, and I'm not done yet. I've got more parts. I've got more stuff. We've got the cab here. Excellent detail. Rivets, mounts for our air tanks. We've got our door handles on there. Beautiful cab, nice looking molding. We've got our interior tub with strong molding on those door panels. Stronger than you think they could get with a tub like that, but it actually looks pretty darn nice. Ready for detailing. We've got that hood, Peterbilt emblems, the seams for our fenders. We've got our strip down the center of the hood. We've got our hinges on the side of the hood, so you could hinge that if you so desired. This one here, we've got our fenders, dashboard, firewall, bunch of air and exhaust lines. We've got our side tanks, so you can either paint them chrome or paint them chassis color. It's up to you. The manual gives lots of call-outs for what colors and how Peterbilt designed their trucks and how they could be ordered. We got the nice sidestep there. We've got our batteries. We've got our passenger seat. We've got our radiator shroud. We've got the big radiator there. We've got parts of our cab. Got a visor for the cab. Can do that any color we wish. We've got all kinds of suspension and brake components. Air tanks. Airbags for the suspension. We got our huge frame rails. There you get an idea of how long that is. Each one of those squares is an inch. That's going to be a big, big frame. Huge parts tree for the diesel engine. Look at all the little parts on there. This one's turbocharged. We got our differentials. Front axles, a big beefy piece of plastic. We've got little parts here. We've got our brake drums, passenger seat, steering wheel. Man, there is just so much plastic to go through in this issue. Oh, get out the big bottle of glue. We've got what looks like air tanks here or parts to the boom. We got an optional front bumper right there. We've got some accessories here. Fuel tanks. What tow truck doesn't have spare fuel tanks? Got a jack so he can lift it up and change a tire, or he can change or get chains underneath it. We got some wood planks on there. We got a nice chrome tree with the rails on the side of the work bed. Handle for the jack. We got our tow hook, fire extinguisher. We got light bars, all kinds of cool stuff. We got those nice wheels, deep dish, chromed out. Looking high, styling. The other side, we've got our lubrifier and our air tanks, or our air cleaner. What else we got going on? We got the sides of the wrecker. That is a lot. That's just the tailgate right there. Top and bottom to an oil drum. This is the front of the wrecker body. We've got lifting devices, straps. We've got the other side, we've got a spare tire, we've got toolboxes and hooks and clamps, and we got a CB radio and a mic, and man, oh man, they just keep going on. We got the shovel there for scraping up all the oil spill, we got a broom for sweeping it off to the side, so much cool stuff. We've got the beautiful flat bed of the tow body done in diamond plate. We've got the giant boom off the back that you can telescope. Say boom again. We got the big chrome bumper on that bad boy. We got the grill. We got some side steps. We got the dual stacks, baby. Yeah. And finally, plastic parts. We've got our springs, drive shafts, frame braces with lightning holes. everything in there. We just have to go through one more thing, and that is we've got our clear yellow and clear red parts. We've got our windshield, we've got our back glass, and our headlights. Time to soak everything in simple green, but wait, I'm not done. You thought I was done. I wanted to save these to the end. We're gonna get 10 pad printed big rig tires. That's right, pad printed Firestones. They look amazing. These are newly tooled up according to AMT, and those look spectacular. Like anybody who loves his big rig is gonna white letter all those tires. So we get 10 of those lovelies. I'm gonna go soak all the parts like I started off saying, and we'll be back for some sub-assemblies. When assembling this kit, now I assemble over 50 kits per year, as you can see on the review channel, and this year I'm on slate to do about 90. This kit does take some time, so I want you to take your time. I would recommend this definitely for someone that has about a dozen kits underneath their belt of glue together kits. What I would do is, if you want this kit, because it is an awesome kit and it is so nice and detailed, and it's an excellent kit, what I recommend is you buy it now while it's available at a great price because it's just been re-released. Pick it up, put it on the shelf, save it for a little bit, and then you're going to be able to build this when you have a little more experience. For those of you that have been building kits for years, go ahead, pick this kit up and dive into it. To get this far has taken me about 6 to 8 hours. I didn't time it exactly, but knowing how much time I spent down in the shop assembling it is about how long it takes. There wasn't any real problems. It's just a little fiddly because you have to wait for certain pieces of glue to dry. Then you can move on to the next step, so it does take a little bit of time. First, we're going to look at stuff that I'm going to be painting here in a little bit. We've got that bumper, that custom front bumper, and I definitely want to use that, so I will be putting that on the side and painting that. We've got our interior ready to go. All you have to do is attach your pedals. That hole in the left is for our steering column, but we've got a clutch, gas, and brake, shifter, and everything will go in after we've decorated the interior. We've got our visor. Now, I love a truck with a visor on it, so this is definitely going to get done. I will be painting this black and then chroming it with my chrome paint, and I will like the look that that has on it. This tree here is all necessary parts. We have a drive shaft, radiator hoses, and our hood hinges, our cab hinges on the front for the entire hood, fender, and radiator assembly to tip forward. So those I will need to be painting, and I will just do those in a black. We've got a bunch of accessories here. I'm not sure which ones I'm going to be using, but we've got our floor brush. We've got our scoop shovel. We've got some safety flags. I glued the toolbox together. We've got our control panel. We've got our CB radio. We've got some jack posts here. So those I'll be deciding. I'm probably just going to hose them down with black and then hand paint them from there. Our exhaust system is like so. I still have to glue that together. It's in halves. I'm going to do that right now. And then I will be painting that a metallic aluminum color. That will be a new exhaust system. I'm doing the truck as a brand new rig because this one I definitely want to do shiny. All my other big rigs I've done weathered up. This one we're going to do as a nice proud tow truck. Those guys usually keep their trucks in pretty darn good condition. We've got our boom support here. That just pushes in. Do not glue this into place. It fits in nice and tight, and you will just rest your boom on there when he's traveling. We've got part of our tow assembly here. Check out the assembly on that in case you have any questions from the instructions. We've got two pieces here. We've got our hooks. We've got our pintle on there, and we've got our attachment point for the hook of the actual boom. And you can see that just kind of swings free. That is going to hang on the back of the rig right on these two attachment points. And then we'll have our hook hooked up to it, and it will hang off the back like so. We've got the winch motors for the boom all set up. That actually assembles on the back like so. And it's got the other boom support on the other side. That goes like so in the back. You'll end up seeing those sitting like that. So that's ready to go with its little winch motor. Looks pretty cool on there. On top of that will sit this pulley. Now you could glue it in place if you don't plan on playing with it, but it's very easy to mount it so that it still spins. And that's what I did. We've got our gear drive there. We've got our pulley support, and that will sit on top of that to control part of the boom up and down with the hook. We've got our spare tire. The spare tire, there is a hook that you attach inside here that we'll see in a minute. We'll paint our spare tire black. We'll hang it on that hook and it'll be inside so that he could pop off a bead. We've got our fuel tanks. He would always have those on board in case all he has to do is just give it a fresh splash of diesel. We've got a large 55-gallon drum. Not sure what's in there, but we want to use that too. We've got our mobile jack. We've got our 2x4s and our 4x8s for what they use for all kinds of bracing and jacking. We're definitely going to be using those. So those will get painted up. We've got our radiator and our radiator shroud. That just needs to be done in a flat black, of course. We've got our air conditioner. You would normally do that in cab color. I'm not sure what color I'm going to do that in, but I do want to use it. I think it's going to look nice mounted on the roof like that with all the other accessories. We've got our boom ready to go. This will be mounted in between those two support arms. We're going to be using super glue to attach everything from here once we put paint on it. And then we've got our extendable boom that just goes in and out real smooth. And this is where our pulley will mount when we're all done. And the boom will sit like so. We'll have a wire or a string, but it'll be a wire running from here to the pulley in front of the truck that we're going to see in a moment. And this will be supported off the back. And then that boom support will come up here and go right in that U-shaped area. So it'll be sitting off the back like that, a nice big tow truck. We've got our air cleaner here. This will be painted and re-chromed by yours truly. That is the airline hose right there that will go in. We've got our lubrifier. That will be painted and attached. Now for the body of the tow rig. You can see it's one nice large assembly. It keys together all on its own. No fit issues with that. You can see these little tabs will help you align everything underneath. I recommend taking one side, gluing your bed to it, and then using everything else to build around it, and you'll square it up very easily, and it will come out. You can see that pulley in front. I attach that. I plan on doing the sides of the body one color, masking off, and spraying the bottom, the work surface, a darker color, and the interior a darker color. So we've got our nice little headache rack here. That'll all be assembled. We got that beautiful diamond plate on the back. We've got our pintle. We've got our two attachment points, and we've got our set for our lights. We've got some steps that'll be going in there. We've got our little mini mud flaps. Underneath are our alignment points for the chassis. This is the part that will slide right down into the chassis. And then we've got our two pads here that will sit. That will just be sprayed outer body color, the same color as these. And then that will be attached so you can see how that looks. That's a nice assembly. The cab, I've got taped together just so you can see how it goes. I also wanted to tape it together so I could align these lower cab attachment points. The lower cab fairings I wanted on there. When we're all done, the hood and radiator and all that are supposed to fold forward. We're going to hope that that lines up correctly. I've drilled all my holes using the markers. I hadn't decided if I wanted to use the air conditioner, so I left the holes for that undrilled, but that'll take 2 seconds to push those through and open them up. But we've got our holes for our cab marker lights, and they've got them spaced out evenly on this one, so that's how we're going to do it. That's how they were molded in the body. And we've got our for our air horns, and he's definitely going to have his air horns on there. What I plan on doing is the cab in one color, then a accent roof and accent fenders on it. That's my plan. So you'll see that coming up in the painting section. But you can see all that lines up. That looks really nice. And that's set to go. We can get some color. The chassis is what will take the longest part of the build. This Peterbilt has an airbag suspension. You can see that assembly back there. That is quite a complicated piece of styrene. All these are multiple pieces of assembly. So follow the manual, take your time, glue your airbags together first, then glue your differentials together, let all that dry, then start putting things together, and you will go step by step. When you put your springs on, attach those to your airbag mounts, get all that set up, then attach your rear differentials, then go on from there and put your brakes on. I'm putting the drums on right away because I want those to be the same frame color. Peterbilt allows you to order the frame in any color they offer, so we're going to be painting that all up in a one color scheme that will work with the cab and the tow body, but be a little bit different, just a tad different, so it draws a minor amount of attention to itself. So that's how that's going to set up. It is absolutely beautiful. It goes together. The front suspension can be a little tricky. I had someone that already built one of these show me where the shocks went, and then I also looked up some pictures online, and you can see how those went on there. One, a manual says one inside, one outside, so I followed their advice and it lined up with the mounts just fine. We got our front axle and our front brakes and our steering mechanism. We've got one fuel tank. He's not a long haul trucker. He doesn't have to have two fuel tanks on there. We've got our battery box and our reserve air tank. So that all looks fantastic and lines up quite well. So we shouldn't have any problems when we get towards the end of anything being off the ground or not being lined up cattywampus. If it is, I will mention it and tell you how I fixed it. We won't know until the body and the tow bed are loaded on permanently. We're not done with parts. I just had to jump over and grab another tray of them. We've got the giant inline six with turbo on this one. The auto car did not have the turbo hooked up. This one is ready to go with its intercooler, the turbo assembly, everything. The manual says Peterbilt painted the entire assembly white, and that's what we're going to do. This is going to be a new truck, so it's just going to be painted a white color with over black. So we got our pre-shadows, and we're pretty much done with that, unless I feel like accenting something else, you know, the air hoses and stuff like that. But they say it's all painted white from the factory to give it a clean appearance by Peterbilt, and that is a sharp-looking engine assembly. Our wheels are ready to go. You just have to glue the flanges on the outside of the wheels, and those are set to go. You can tell the inside from the outside based on where the bolts are on each one. We've got our passenger seat glued together, ready for interior paint. We've got our driver's seat with its nice air ride on there and swivel. That's ready for paint. I sanded down the inside of the smokestack so we could use model glue to join those together. Those are ready for paint. I will be re-chroming those so that they have a more consistent tone to them. Otherwise, dealing with it after I've made a mess with the glue and all that, trying to clean that chrome up, why bother? I can just paint. We've got our dashboard glued together. Look at all the gauges on that thing. We're going to have to be working on those by hand. We've got our steering wheel glued together. I love using model glue on stuff if I can because it welds it together. We've got our fan ready for paint. The hubs will be a contrasting to the color of the frame and the brake rotors or the brake drums. So I wanted to leave those separate. I can attach those later. And then we've got things like our rear wheels. We've got our front wheels with the lugs out. All of these are going to be set down like so and sprayed with new chrome. I'm going to be primering them and spraying with new chrome. So I'm going to be re-chroming pretty much everything just because I like that little bit of a duller tone to it compared to the plastic on the model. So I'm going to start heading over to paint. Paint's going to take a while. Come along with. Thank you. My idea was for a truck with really strong contrast that would really stand out on the side of a highway, towing big rigs and fixing up accident scenes, and that's exactly what I'm going to get by using those two lacquers from Testers. Now, we're going to take a look at just some of the parts that were painted. The rest, of course, you saw in the painting section. I love the way that chrome paint gives me a subdued look of metal on there. It still looks like chrome. It's shiny, but it's not as shiny as the factory beautiful chrome from AMT. I've got that front bumper. I haven't decided if I'm going to use that cattle guard on the front or not, but I've got it on there. I've got it painted, so we'll decide. We can leave it on there. We can not put it on there, whatever we choose when we get towards the end. The smokestacks look awesome, all painted up, re-chromed with that paint. They're going to look great sitting on either side of the cab there. Those are going to look pretty tough. I like that dual exhaust. I've got the exhaust pipes themselves painted. This is being done as a new truck, pretty much as it was delivered, so we're not going to be crusting or rusting or beating anything up. This big rig, finally, one of the big rigs I built on the channel, will actually be in a nice pristine condition. The seats have been painted in their initial tone. The cushions, I'm going to go in on both of them and do them in a little bit of a darker seat tone. The dashboard, I'm going to do the top of the dash black so that it's not reflective, and then I'm going to go in and hand paint the individual dial gauges, the little buttons, the levers, and the switches. I will just be using some black paint or a black marker to go in. Then I will be doing a surround and a silver gel pen that we'll see in a minute, and then I will be using a silver pencil to bring out the highlighted detail. You're going to be able to see little to nothing once it's inside the cab, since we got the back on it, so that's not a big deal. The interior, I will be enhancing the door panels a little bit with a little detail, and then painting my three work pedals there, and then mounting the seats. The interior also, not much will be seen, so I'm not going to go into an extreme amount of work on it. The hubs are bright yellow. The rear wheels are chrome. That's going to look nice when those are mounted on the back like that. The front hub is a blue as the chassis. I'm going to enjoy that contrast with those wheels. I've done some of the accessories up. I did a bare metal look on the 55-gallon drum. That will end up mounting over here. Can't mount it over here because that's where the spare tire will hang. I've got a fuel can full of diesel, and I've got a fuel can full of gasoline. Depending on who he has to go help, it depends on what kind of fuel, so I'm assuming he would carry both types with him. We've got a lot of the winch mounting stuff all done. We've got our two posts that'll sit in the bed here. We've got our rear tow bar that's all painted up and still moves and flexes, and we've got our upper pulley for the winch itself. We've got our wheels done in that chrome, and that looks lovely. I like how those stand out now. We've also did our side step for the passenger side fuel tank. That'll be a little bit of a contrast on all that blue over there from the fuel tank, so that looks great. Moving on to the chassis and the engine and everything else. We've got this sitting here. I love the look of it with that bright yellow and bright blue. Too bad I don't have a bunch of Napa emblems. That would be the coolest looking Napa truck ever. I've got the boom, and that's how it's going to mount in there. Of course, we're going to have our other pulleys, and it's going to be situated higher up here. So that's all ready to go. We can remove that. The boom will still slide if you want it to with the paint on it. I'm not ever going to be using it like that, but it still will if you wish it to. And then this will pull out. That's our boom support. The bed looks awesome with its two-tone. I wanted that rail to stay yellow, but then the interior to be blue, the headache rack to be blue on both sides. Then I clear coated it. All this needs is a little bit of detail work on the access boxes, and we need to attach our side marker lights, our tail lights, our back steps, and whatnot, other little small details, but that looks lovely. And that diamond plate shows up good under paint. About a week after he'd already owned this, most of that would be scuffed off the top of the diamond plate anyways. On the cab, we've got our air conditioner, which I haven't drilled in yet because I still haven't decided if I want to mount it up there or if I just want to leave it a blue roof as follows. So I still haven't decided. Of course, the roof's going to have marker lights and horns, so I painted the air conditioner just to make sure I had it if I decided to mount that up there. It'll just have to be a decision that I make, you know, I decide on my own. But that looks lovely with the hood and the fenders, the different color, and that will mount over the top, and it closely matches the blue I used on the chassis, but not a perfect match. So that's going to look awesome. On the cab, I have to do all my detail work, all my trim around the windows, the doors. We have to do our door handles. We have to, of course, once we're done, get our decals on, all our hood ornaments and emblems. The engine, the manual says Peterbilt used white, so that's exactly what I did. I misted white over the black, gave me a lot of cool shadows. This requires very little work since we're doing it as a new engine. I will be hand painting the belt work. That'll be real quick and easy. I will be hand painting this hose. I might paint the turbo, but I'm not quite sure. I'll be painting a grip on the oil filler. And on this side, the filters here will be painted. But the rest is going to stay as a full assembly painted white on a brand new Peterbilt that just mounts in there. The chassis is that navy blue from Rust-Oleum. We did the whole thing up all in one with the drums and everything so that it looks good behind the wheels. And hopefully it came down the assembly line like that. It said you can paint the tanks and the steps all as one in the manual. So I just followed their advice, did it all together, and got it all painted as one, so that everything lines up and matches beautifully. So that step will be hanging over the tank. That'll give us a little bit of variation on that. And we'll be doing the cap, of course, in a chrome color. So this is all ready to go. What I have to do now is I'm going to dig in and get the dash painted, get the seats painted, get the interior painted, get those seats covered up with a little bit of a darker tone, get that all assembled and ready to go, do my little bit of detail painting on the engine assembly, because the black shadows already give enough of a detail, it looks lovely. Get the radiator mounted in the front, stuff like that. Get our hood and grill assembly with the hinges put together. Do the trim on the cab, and we'll be back for a little bit of an update. I can tell you with great confidence that as the build goes along, the truck, of course, becomes more and more delicate, so you really need to be careful with it. We've got the engine painted up with its minor details, just did that airline and the cap, the alternator, attached the radiator to the front and glued all that in place. So that is all set, that's done. That's one of the last times we're gonna look at it from that angle. This is all gonna be sealed up over the top. Our cab is gonna go there. Our hood is roughly gonna be there. Of course, we don't have an interior in to hold anything in place. So that's how that's going to look. As far as the cab, the glass is in. The glass completely fits with pressure only, not a drop of glue. It fits so nice and tight that all you have to do is press it in place. We've got our trim done, and that's it. We got our trim around the windows done, our door handles. That's all that needs to be done as far as that before we put on final pieces. The interior is ready to go up inside, so I wanted to show it to you guys before we finished. You can see what I did was I used a black Sharpie to do the gauges, just a fine line marker. You can get those anywhere. It is just the super fine point, the little pen. Then I used a silver gel pen to surround the gauges. And then I used a silver pencil, it does not matter the brand, to go in and you gently rub the raised surface, and that will bring your gauge parts out, your gauge readings out. Blacked off the top of the dash, did the interior seats, got the pedals, got the shifter, just need to black the top of the shifter knob so that he is all ready to go and haul out and do some trucking. The steering wheel is a basic black, so I didn't do any work with that. I got the stacks glued up correctly. Those will go underneath here. And line up with the exhaust pipe that we attached earlier. And we line those up, so all I have to do is glue them on, and they will stick up where they should be in relation to the cab. This is all very hard to do with just one set of hands and have you see it, but they'll be right around there, and they will touch the back of the cab with their cab braces on either side. We'll be able to glue those in place. Once the cab is completely in place, then we'll do the exhaust so we can line everything up. We got our cab visor all ready. Once we start attaching our accessories, he's going to go on like a so and look all sweet up there. I decided to leave the air conditioner off the cab. I did not drill the holes. I'm just going to leave it and attach my other chrome accessories. There'll be more than enough activity on the roof. You must know that these are the skinny little hood hinges. It's supposed to be a tilting hood. When you're all done with this rig, you're supposed to be able to tilt the hood all the way forward. Well, for the millionth time, I'm going to say I don't play with my models, so that kind of functionality matters not to me whatsoever. Neither does a boom that slides out or any of that stuff. It just simply doesn't matter to me. I put them together and they never get touched again. But that will end up, when you get those hinges glued on the back of the radiator, which must be attached to the hood, those will go into those little holes right there on either side. And then once your bumper is attached, you are supposed to be able to slide everything forward and leave the engine exposed and all that. Now, I'm not going to worry about any of that, but that is what that's supposed to do. I will likely get everything in place, touch each hinge with a drop of glue to hold it, and be done with it. So we'll see if I can still tilt it forward and get some pictures of it in the final. We'll find out. But I definitely won't be able to do it on camera because it's such a delicate procedure, and I don't want to snap those hinges off. So it is delicate. Take your time. Make it work if you so desire such functionality. The wheels entire package is done. I just do the white letters facing out on both sides, even though you can only see the outside of the truck. So those are going to look great with their colored hubs. The rear will have yellow hubs, and the front will have the blue hubs on the brake drums. So that's all set. So we'll set that stuff aside. I'm hauling towards the final. I've taken both of the pulleys and wrapped wire around them, and then I will run those over the booms, and those will be all set. That's just regular craft wire. Get it at any craft store. It's 24 gauge. That's all you need to know. And then I colored the spool black so you can't tell exactly how much cable is on there. On the tow body, we've got the boom ready to go. We've got one mount locked in with glue. We've got this just pressed in. The boom support is so stiff that it just presses in, so you don't even have to worry about that. Roughly, the boom will sit there. We'll have our support back here. It'll actually mount off, of course, the floor. I've got the blue pulley up front wrapped with wire. That actually only attaches to this point here on the boom to make it go up and down in real life. So that will be looped through, kinked around, and then cut free. The other wire will be brought up. There is a pulley that sits up here. That is our upper pulley. The wire from the upper pulley goes down over the center pulley and down to this mechanism here, which will hang off the back and be held up with our hook. Of course, it'll be straight when I'm done, but it's just holding together for the perfectionists there. So you can see it just will kind of hang there. The main hook will come over, reach down, and be attached to that little board down there, so that's our tow package. So everything has to get glued in place, but I don't want to do any of this until I get this body attached to the chassis. So when I get the cab attached, when I get the hood attached, and then I will go ahead and attach the tow body so we can line everything up. Then I'll do the wheels and tires to make sure that they center out correctly. You can make any tiny adjustments you need. If you have your drums and you didn't get an exact perfect lineup underneath the truck, this is where you can use that large inside rim to kind of make your adjustments. Now, if someone flips it over, they're going to go, well, you know, that wheel is the eighth of an inch off the center. But that's their problem in life. I wouldn't worry about it. What I'm telling you is a lot of you guys have problems building these trucks and you have a problem with lining up your wheels perfectly and your axles. So that's where you can make up that difference. See how that moves around on there? That's where you can make up your difference on any small mistakes, is with that eighth of an inch. You can level everything out, get it centered, make it look right. If you're off more than an eighth of an inch, you are up you know what creek. But for little minor adjustments, because these older style chassis can be a little difficult to line up, that is what you're going to want to do. I'm going to keep working on everything. When I come back, we will have that beautiful final. Here it is, the extra big 1/25th scale Peterbilt wrecker from AMT. This kit hasn't been out in a while and it's been re-released. This was a 3-day build for me, which means it takes a little bit longer than your average kit. That auto car dump truck I just did a while ago, that one I got out in only a couple days. So this kit is for the experienced modeler. I do not recommend this as a first glue model kit, but I would say if you have at least a half a dozen, maybe, that's the number I'm going to go with at the final here, about a half a dozen glue kits, you're used to having to improvise some fits because these older kits will need a little bit of fit work, a little bit of cutting here or there, shaving apart, depending on how you're building it. Just a little bit of X-Acto knife work. You're not going to have to rebuild any parts. You're not going to have to redesign the vehicle. Just a little extra shaving with the knife. You know, you got a little part that doesn't quite fit perfect. You'll just shave a little bit off with a knife. It won't just fall together. So the most complicated part of the build is that tilting hood. Now, by the time I went and put the different front bumper on there that's in the kit, my hood no longer tilts all the way forward. You can see that clearance issue where if it tilts forward, that bottom part of the grill comes and contacts that front bumper. So I did not actually go and start tearing it back apart to figure out why it doesn't swing forward anymore. We're just going to leave it as is, assembled as a beautiful display kit. If you want that front hood to come all the way over, you'll either have to omit this front bumper completely or engineer that and figure out why those hinges no longer tilt forward when that goes forward there. You might have to lengthen the hinges. You might have to work on them a little bit, but it's a beautiful kit nonetheless on display. I've got all the different toys and accessories on it. I decided not to go with the air conditioner. I figured the top of the roof looked pretty busy as it is with just the marker lights and the air horns where they have the holes pre-marked underneath, and with the airfoil on the top, the visor, the mirrors, the dual stacks with handles. I figured, well, it's pretty busy as it is. We'll leave it alone. I love the work bed on this thing. We got the drum, the tire, the shovels, the broom, the wood, the 4x8s and the 2x4s that they'll use for jacking. We got the toolbox, we got the diesel, we got the fuel, we got the jack, and I put the CB antenna right behind the cab where they would have drilled it through in a safe spot. We even got the red spotlights on the back of the cab per the directions. I used some vinyl cable and wire to make my tow cable. None of that is included. I even got the little control box mounted back here. If you wanted, you could take some more vinyl or string and make a cable to somewhere in here as it controls it. That's how I rigged mine up. You can either do the same or do it a little different. I like it so that that tail hangs off the back and it's kind of supporting the weight of it. I like that look. It's even got gorgeous little steps back here on the tailgate. It's got these cute little steps with footholds that go in. We've got our tail lights look wonderful. We've got our amber hazards. We've got our backup lights, which are decals. We've got our Michigan plate on there because I went with the Grand Rapids Peterbilt emblems. I love those and it looks fantastic. I black washed the grill and rubbed it in. So you get that kind of, when you see these trucks in the sunshine, they kind of fade in and out when you see that little squiggly pattern on the grill because it's so thin. So that's how I wanted to do mine, so it stood out a little bit. We've got our marker lights, we've got our headlights on each side, we've got our air tank, we've got that nice chrome step on the fuel tank to get into the passenger door, and then I accented, we've got these beautiful little marker lights that glue on. Those are all separate parts. It's a really nice kit. I think the only things I would change if I redid the kit was I definitely would paint these hubs blue, the same as the chassis, instead of yellow, the body color. I might use a little bit of a lighter blue, but I really like the yellow on there. And I do like the yellow and blue look. I think that's a striking color combination. This would definitely be seen on the side of the highway helping people out. So otherwise, other than that, beautiful kit, has all the parts you need. This is built right out of the box, except for the string and the vinyl tubing and the wire that I used as the supports. You could use string. That's the only thing that's not included. This is otherwise built right out of the box, and you saw how I painted it and detailed it and got it going, and it is absolutely lovely. Can't wait to put this one on the shelf. We will be back with another kit review. As always, I want to thank the peeps at Round 2. Very cool for sending these out, giving me a chance to build them up for you guys so you can see how they look when they're all done. And we will see you at the next kit review.